What if you need to do two-way lookup? Like in this particular table, I have got fruits in one column, and then every column is a different month of sale. And I want to do a lookup, and every time I do a lookup, I have two criterias now. One is for the fruit, and the other one is for the month. Now you can see that the month is changing. Hence, every time I write down the month, I need to have the column reference as well. So how do we do it? The easiest way to do this is by using a match function. The match function will actually give you the column reference number, which keeps changing with every month. So first of all, let me just name this entire range as fruits, which I've already done over here. I've called this table as fruits. Now in the first cell over here, fruits, let me put a data validation. I put a list, and the list that I select is these fruits. Put an OK, and I can see that I have a drop down over here. For month, I will use a data validation again, and this time I will use a list for the months, and OK. As I said earlier, our challenge this time is that with every changing month, our column reference is also going to change. So we need to determine this column reference. Let's see how we can do it using the match function. Let me just select first of all any particular month over here. And here what I'm going to do is that I'm going to use the match function for now, equal to match. Now what is my lookup value? It is this particular month, comma, the lookup array. My lookup array is this entire row where I have the months, comma, and I need an exact match, so I'll put down a zero, bracket close, and enter. So you can see that it's showing me the number 4 over here as an answer, which means that March is the fourth column from the fruits. Let's see if it's correct or not. 1, 2, 3, 4. That's right. And as and when I change the month over here, this number is also changing. So now we have all the different criteria that we need for VLOOKUP over here. Let's say I want the sale of apples in the month of March. So for now, let me just highlight it with a color so that we know the match is correct or not. So I'm going to select apples, and I'm going to select March. And my simple function would be equal to VLOOKUP. The lookup value here is apples because I'm searching for apples, comma, table array. Table array is this entire array which I have named as fruits, comma, column index number is the number that I got using the match function, which is this particular number, comma, I want an exact match, so it's going to be zero. So there you go. You can see that the result is matching. Now let's say I want the sale of avocados in the month of May. This one. So I will select avocados, and here I'll select May. So you can see that the number is matching. So you can see that how you can use VLOOKUP and match together to make sure that every time the column number is changing, it's also captured using the match function. Now the last thing what I can do is that whatever here I used as a function, I can copy it, go to the VLOOKUP function, and here in J9, I replace it with the exact function over here, and then I can just delete it. So now this is how you can use VLOOKUP with multiple criteria.
And yes, if you haven't already, please subscribe to the channel and press the bell icon to get notified every time a new video is uploaded.